हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू द प्रैक्टिकल सेशन ऑफ कोर्स पैथ 354, दैट इज़ प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑन डिसीजेस ऑफ टमाटो. ड्यूरिंग लास्ट प्रैक्टिकल वी डिस्कस्ड द प्रैक्टिकल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑन डिसीजेस ऑफ कोकोनट. सो लेट्स सी वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट डिसीज दैट इज डैम्पिंग ऑफ, विच इज़ कॉज्ड बाय फंजाई पिथियम अफानीडर्मैटम और पिथियम डबेरियानम. So how to identify the disease? The disease, it occurs in two stages. First, that is a pre-emergence, second post-emergence. In case of first pre-emergence stage, seedlings, these are killed just before they reach the soil surface and leading to complete rotting. Then in case of second, that is a post-emergence infection, it occurs at the collar region and the infected tissue becomes soft, leads to collapsing. Next, in case of etiology, the mycelium, it is hyaline, sinocytic, branched, and the sporangia, these are born on sporangiophore, and they germinate to form zoospores, and zoospores, this is formed by anthridium and eugonium, and these are found, thick brownish in appearance, found in the root cells. These are the structures. Next, in case of disease cycle, pathogen survives in the soil or seed in the form of oospores, and damping conditions or ill-drained soils favors disease development, which develops symptoms, that is pre and post emergence damping off and secondary infection. It occurs by zoospores from the sporangia. These are spread by irrigation or rainwater. Next disease, that is Fusarium wilt, which is caused by a fungi, Fusarium oxysporum F. species Lycopersici. In this case, we have already discussed symptoms many times. So, leaves, these show yellowing symptoms, and important symptom, that is a drooping and a wilting. And infected tissue, if you cut it down, you will see the browning of vascular system. Then the mycelium, it is septate and hyaline. Next, in case of etiology, mycelium, it is septate, hyaline, microconidia, these are one-celled. Then hyaline, ovoid to elliptical, then macroconidia, these are fusoid, 3 to 5 septate and pointed at both the ends. Then in case of next, that is disease cycle, the chlamydospores, this causes the primary infection in the case of wilt, which survives in the soil, seed and plant debris. In plant debris, they can survive for around or more than 10 years. Then root knot nematode population and temperature, that is around 28 degrees Celsius, favors the disease development and shows the symptom like yellowing, wilting and vascular discoloration. And secondary infection occurs with the help of conidia by irrigation or wind. Next disease, that is early blight, which is caused by Alternaria solani. You can see the symptom here. Lower leaves, these are affected first and disease progresses upwards. Then leaves, these are small. Then in case of leaves, small brown black circular lesions, these are developed. And in case of old foliage, later concentric rings are formed. These are surrounded by yellow halo. Also, it affects on the stem and fruit. Similar lesions appears on the infected portion. In case of etiology, mycelium, it is a brownish septate. Then it on develops conidiophore. On conidiophore, conidia, these are developed in chain. These are beaked and muriform, divided by transverse and longitudinal septa. In case of disease cycle, the pathogen, it requires high temperature and relative high humidity. Then pathogen, it survives in the plant debris in the soil, for around 3 years, also in the seed, in the form of mycelium, then develops symptom that is a dark brown concentric rings, and secondary infection, it occurs by conidia. Next disease, that is a late blight, which is caused by Phytophthora infestans. It attacks upper leaves first, and disease progresses downwards. You can see clearly see the symptom, the brown greasy lightening patches on the affected portion leading to defoliation. Then cool nights favors the disease. And disease cycle we already discussed in previous crop. So next disease, that is leaf curl, which is caused by tomato leaf curl virus. So in this case, vector, it is a white fly, that is Bemisia tabaci. And in case of symptoms, downward rolling and crinkling of leaves. And in case of older leaves, these are found leathery, brittle, and bushy in appearance. Transmission, it occurs by grafting and white fly. Next disease, that is mosaic, caused by tomato mosaic virus, stands for TMV. Then regarding symptoms, light and dark green mottling on leaves, then these are puckered smaller, leading to fern leaf symptoms, that is smaller than normal leaf. Virus spreads by contact with the clothes, then hands of working labor, then touching of infected plant with healthy one or implements. And avoid solanaceous plants. Then next, that is last one, Burkeye rot, which is caused by Phytophthora nicotiani. You can see the symptom, that is initially water soaked spots or grayish green, which later turns brownish on fruit. Then since fruit contacts the soil and develops symptom, resemble bull's eye like alternate dark and light brown concentric rings, and these are smooth lesions, and they cover more than half region of fruit, and they resemble markings of buckeye chestnuts after rotting. So the disease name is buckeye rot. Severe in non-stick tomato plants in poor drain areas, and warm temperature favors the disease development. And in case of etiology and disease cycle, we already discussed the etiology of Phytophthora in the previous sessions. So far we studied the practical aspects on tomato diseases. Stay home, stay safe, study online, take care.